there's like this expectation that a lot of people have when you say the word Frankenstein.
We must consider that it may be in pain.
I think what's really fascinating in this version is the creature is very human, and we see this growth from almost what Brendan has done, from almost baby-like mannerisms to becoming a fully rational human being.
Discovered a sense of the creature as he is represented in lots of different versions, but particularly the 1994 movie with Robert De Niro made a point of a kind of past life that sort of imprinted and inhabited the body that was reanimated. And that sense of a moment in that film where he began to pick up a flute, a recorder, and play, sort of as a memory of a life past.
Victor, what will we do with him?
With him?
Yes, have you not thought of
we'll examine him, every function, every reflex. Victor!
We're going to use these like really small cast prosthetics to have this like suture mark across the top of the head so that you have some kind of opening to where you could get and put a brain inside. And then we'll also look at the same kind of suture marks, like down where the heart would be placed in and the other vital organs.
Finding all these little nuances there and this depth there that on the first read you don't see, but once you get into exploring the relationships, they're there. And that's really exciting. It's challenge, it's frustrating at times, but it's really, really very exciting.
Hurry, Henry, there's no time to lose!